A term hepatitis refers to an inflammatory condition of the liver. However, an exact definition of hepatitis differs from a clinical and morphological point of view. In clinical practice, this term is reserved for infectious hepatitis and autoimmune hepatitis. But many other diseases may show a histological picture of hepatitis. For example, some metabolic diseases, drug-induced hepatopathies, or some disorders of the biliary tree, namely primary biliary cholangitis. Apart from that, inflammation often comes as a secondary reaction to previously non-inflammatory liver damage, such as ischemic necrosis. Thus, from a morphological or microscopical point of view, a term hepatitis is not a specific diagnosis, but a common morphological pattern, mutual for many diseases, both infective and non-infective. Sometimes we can see additional morphological changes which can point us to a specific disease. However, the final diagnosis is impossible to be reached without clinical data and proper clinical setting. Hepatitis can be classified as acute and chronic. From a clinical point of view, chronic hepatitis is defined as inflammation lasting for at least 6 months. But there is a difference at the morphological level too. Morphology of acute hepatitis is characteristic for viral hepatitis A and some drug-induced hepatopathies. In some cases, viral hepatitis B can manifest as both acute and chronic hepatitis. Microscopically, acute hepatitis is characterized by changes in liver lobule, while portal spaces often remain untouched. In the picture, there is inflammation localized predominantly in the centrilobular region, with predominance of lymphocytes and plasma cells. Hepatocytes are altered and regressed. They are starting to swell and undergo ballooning degeneration. Swollen hepatocytes don't fit in trabecules, and physiological trabecular pattern of liver parenchyma is disrupted. The architecture of the liver lobule is less arranged, and this phenomenon is called lobular disarray. As time passes, hepatocytes die by necrosis and apoptosis. In case of severe acute hepatitis, the inflamed and necrotic centrilobular zones of liver lobules may merge and create centrocentral or centroportal bridging necrosis. Bridging necrosis may be seen in chronic hepatitis as well, but they are more typical for acute hepatitis. Microscopical picture of chronic hepatitis is typical for chronic viral hepatitis B and C, or autoimmune hepatitis. Also, some metabolic diseases, drug-induced hepatopathies, or disorders of biliary tree may manifest as chronic hepatitis, as stated before. Microscopically, chronic hepatitis is characterized by inflammation in portal tracts, with a predominance of lymphocytes and plasma cells again. As the activity of the disease increases, the inflammation may penetrate borders of portal tracts and infiltrate a surrounding zone of periportal hepatocytes. This microscopical pattern, which is composed of inflammation both at the border of a portal tract and in the periportal zone, together with damaged periportal hepatocytes, is called interface hepatitis. The older term is piecemeal necrosis. You can see it in this picture. There are portal tracts expanded by fibrosis and infiltrated by dense chronic inflammation. The inflammatory cells cross the borders of the portal tracts and damage periportal hepatocytes in the interface fashion. Often we can see small inflammatory foci, so-called necroinflammatory changes in liver lobules as well. In case of marked inflammation activity, The inflammation can reach centrilobular zone and create bridging necrosis. In this phase, it may be very difficult to differentiate chronic and acute hepatitis solely on morphological grounds. In the course of time, the inflammation is healed by fibrosis. We can often see development of septal fibrosis, and the disease may progress to cirrhosis. For details about fibrosis and cirrhosis, see our corresponding video. In some cases, we can appreciate other morphological details that can lead us to a specific diagnosis. In chronic viral hepatitis B, there is an overproduction of viral surface antigen during replication of the virus. This protein is stored in cytoplasm of hepatocytes, which grants them ground glass appearance. Such cytoplasm is homogeneously eosinophilic, hazy and slightly granular. We don't see this in acute viral hepatitis B, only in a chronic phase. Chronic hepatitis C often manifests as steatohepatitis. Autoimmune hepatitis is characterized by very intense chronic hepatitis with marked interface activity and numerous plasma cells in the inflammatory infiltrate. It's often combined with a primary sclerosing cholangitis. In that case, we can see a combination of both chronic hepatitis and signs of chronic obstructive cholestasis in microscopy. This so-called overlap syndrome is common, especially in pediatric age.